is finally here. And while that necessarily doesn't mean lower temperatures, it does mean one thing. The spooky season is upon us, and a little bit of cooler weather is also here. How's it going, Rams? My name is Morgan, here to give you the rundown on all things weather. Starting off with current conditions, it is 72 degrees outside, mostly clear, not too many clouds. Some winds, 7 miles per hour, north-northwest, and the sunset at 6:53. And this narrative continues throughout the region tonight. Pretty quiet evening across the board. Across over here in the eastern region, Burlington at 49, Lamar at 48, and Sterling over there at 44. Well, across on the western region, we have Vail at 38, Gunnison at 31, and Telluride at 40. Well, Alamosa is down there at 32, making it a pretty chilly evening as well for them. As we look into tomorrow's forecast, it's pretty consistent across the board as well. As we can see here, there's a lot of 77s on the board. So Craig up there at 77, Fort Collins at 77, Sterling at 77, and Lyman at 77. Lamar over there at 84 degrees. Well, Telluride gets its nice taste of the fall weather at 66 degrees. And there's been some record highs and record lows this summer season and going into fall. Denver had a record high. Denver had a record hot weekend, but NoCoTown was the coldest in the U.S. And as we go into tomorrow's forecast, 77 degrees, partly cloudy, with a little bit of wind 8 miles an hour east-southeast. Sunrise at 6:49 a.m. and sunset at 6:53. And record highs and record lows throughout the region this year. Denver had a record hot weekend, but NoCoTown was the coldest in the U.S. Colorado served us with yet another hot and cold trick this weekend as temperatures reached record heat along the Front Range. It was a way different story up in the mountains, though. According to the National Weather Service, on Saturdays, it was 93 degrees, which set a record for September 18th. The temperature recorded was tied with the previous highest set over 100 years ago in 1895. NWS, National Weather Service for Boulder, tweeted out record high tied at Denver International Airport. Denver International recorded a temperature of 93 degrees this afternoon. This ties a previous record high for Denver, last set in 1895. The Fort Collins area reached the low 90s on Saturday, but less than 100 miles away, Walden, Colorado was setting quite a different record. On Saturday evening, Walden reached 20 degrees and snow was falling from the sky. Needless to say, residents were shocked. Walden resident Robert Ainsworth posted a picture on his Instagram feed after waking up to a blanket of snow in their backyard. So, while the rest of the U.S. was heating up, Walden enjoyed a cool premiere into the fall season. Luckily for us, we won't be receiving any snow this week or anytime soon. And as we hop into our 5-day forecast, it's looking like a cool fall entrance into the week ended quick, as today and the next few days get back into the summertime feel. We see highs well into the 80s before our next cool down arrives by late next week. 85 on Saturday, 88 on Sunday, and 85 on Monday. Minimal cloud coverage too, making it feel like days right smack dab in the middle of June. Overall, fall is waiting a while before making its entrance, unless you're Walden, Colorado, that is. And well, Rams, that is all the time I have with you on weather tonight, but stick around after the break for more news.